Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. We're on to the divisional round now, two steps away from playing on the biggest stage in sports. It's the Buccaneers going up against the Giants. With that, let's get up to MetLife Stadium as we welcome in our guys, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Larry, EA Sports coverage of the NFL finds us at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. Ahead, we'll decide the second entrant to next week's NFC title game as we've got a great one in store between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the New York Giants. Some changes here as the D-line separates some. They'll try and run with their fullback across the 30 to the 31-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight.
And that's the defense that they were looking for, being able to get extra bodies to the point of attack to deal with the big guy carrying the ball. You really don't want to be in a position where it's a one-on-one tackle with him. Because he has such great skills, you want to utilize him in all aspects of your passing offense.
And there he was in the slot for the catch. On the give, this is their fullback. And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. Given three on first down, it'll set up a second and seven. And a lot of the weight of this offense falls on the shoulders of the running back.
That's because the offense knows if they give him any openings, any opportunities, he can turn it into a big play at any time.
Decent chunk of yardage still left here, second and seven. And some extras coming up on the line here, ready for the blitz. Now a second down throw for Winston. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. Touchdown, Tampa Bay! A big play there. 48 yards. And the Bucs have taken a first quarter lead. Getting your back involved, what's the importance there in the passing game?
Well, oftentimes you can create mismatches because who's going to cover him? And you get him into space, which is where he likes to operate with the ball in his hands. Oftentimes makes people miss, gets that run after the catch, and off he goes.
And into the end zone. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. They'll come out in the pistol.
Second down. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
through the contact. Incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes with people trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
On fourth down, here's Brian Anger now to kick this one away. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. And that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback. Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers.
Frankly, Brandon, we're talking about things I'm not sure we ever thought we'd talk about in the NFL. And a lot of that is the speed of the linebacker position. A lot of these guys in college, they were safeties. They moved them up to outside linebacker to combat the spread offenses. And now we're seeing it in the NFL. Those same guys using their speed to make plays in the backfield, similar to that one.
So here's his starting 11, and the human highlight reel, Odell Beckham Jr., watch out for him.
One of the few guys in the league that gets you and I out of our hotel rooms early to get here for pregame warm-ups and watch him go through his routine. He's absolutely amazing catching the football.
Incomplete pass on second down. Let's see what the offense draws up here on
now,
third.
Let's go. Leopard. Blue landing.
Play action. They'll throw. He's going to air one.
Offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about five or six plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays, and you don't get many opportunities to dial them up, and they just did, and they drop it with a great chance to make a big play. That's going to hurt.
And he'll take it just outside the 40. A good return there, 17 yards, and the Buccaneer offense will be set up well as they take over. Set to take over again. They're out in front. Last time they had a punt away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They want to go out and punt away. This team has to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Winston to throw it this time. He's got a rifle one deep left side. Mike Evans, the one he was looking for. And it's third and short. And quickly the starting 11 now for the New York defense.
Dominique Rodgers-Cromartie is one of those tall corners that fools you with his ability to change directions. DRC can play.
And they're definitely showing blitz here.
Looks like a mix set here defensively on 32.
And maybe expecting a throw. But he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line. Now we're going to get a timeout. Here's we've got an injured Buccaneer. We'll get an update when we return to MetLife Stadium. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. Now a handoff here to his running back. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. It'll go as a gain of 12. And the Buccaneers are going to have a first down.
Love the run right there. And when you analyzed him coming out of college, when you tried to put a grade on him, you saw the flashes while he was in school, but you didn't see the full production. You didn't see the finished product. He's a little bit raw, but you can see why people...
And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. A great play there with his second touchdown in this opening quarter. And the Bucs are going to add on to their lead. And it's good to make it 14-0. The Bucs ready for the kickoff. And here we go. It's in the air. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Giants offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And the last drive, their first drive, three and out. What changes here, if anything?
I think it's making sure the guys that you trust the most with the ball, the biggest playmakers you have, that they touch it on this possession to try and get things moving.
So get it to the horses.
Without a doubt, they're the ones that typically end up in the end zone.
Finding time. Now he'll throw deep. That's caught inside the 20. And he gets this game deep into Tampa Bay territory. A big play there for the Giants. 69 yards. Snap coming inside the red zone here. They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. No gain on the play there. It'll be second down. The starting 11 defensively for Tampa Bay.
Gerald McCoy is one of the top defensive tackles in the league. Always a threat to go to the Pro Bowl, especially because of his pass rushing ability.
They come up with an offset. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the one. Give it right around four on the carry. We'll see if they want to keep pounding here on third and goal. Come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. So they held him out on second down, and now here's third and goal. They come out here in the
air. Here we go.
It's a quarterback sneak. Only a yard there, so it brings up fourth and goal.
Well, they gave it a shot, quarterback sneak. Not able to get it.
No, but if you're going to call a QB sneak on third down, you draw it up to get it.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Maybe they were thinking four down territory.
Is going to stay out there. We'll see what the play call is. They need to find the right one here on fourth and goal. They've come out with one back and three tight ends. And they're going to the ground attack here. And touchdown in the end zone for Giant TD. A great effort there. Taking it in. And the Giants have got it back to a one-score game. Makes it 14-7. The kickoff unit is out on the field and they will send this one away. Fairly short kick, taking it to 14 here. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They've got to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got that great confidence having scored the last time out.
That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
I like that they took a shot downfield, but it was well covered. He's able to get a hand in and knock it away.
So the incomplete pass brings up second down. They'll come out in the pistol. Again, we see the pistol here. And he fires one, but it's intercepted. A great lead, it's picked up. And here are the Tigers
they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Your live stream, whack you fake ass bitch. Wasp. Giants suck.
And we've got a good one brewing. We're all knotted up at 14. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, and it's the Giants with a football here as we begin quarter number two, as we'll see one following the score on the final play before break. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. Zone for a touchback. Now the Buccaneers offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my own college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. But they're hoping is that last mistake is their own.
Mundo.
Coaches, that's all they talk about.
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
And they're able to get this one across the 35. So there you go, holding by the offense, and that'll push him back.
Changes everything now as you try and figure out what your playbook has for you. Longer yardage situations, tougher to execute and pick up first downs.
They'll send the receiver in motion left.
You dumb bitch, you suck dick for free, and your girlfriend ugly as hell. Yeah, you suck.
I think he's going to be special.
Watch it now, Barney! Barney!
Now on first down, he'll drop the throw. And he fires one that's intercepted. But Green and it's picked off. And the return this time will go up to the 42-yard line. Here comes the Tampa Bay offense now heading back out onto the field.
Confidence in him and let him throw another one.
9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a second and one.
some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front. Really well done.
So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down. See what the defense dials up here. Third and four. One receiver to the left is Evans. To throw, Winston. Oh, he's got a man wide open. Complete. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. Now we're going to get a timeout. Here's we've got an injured Buccaneer. We'll get an update when we return to MetLife Stadium. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. And he'll keep it moving down to the 15-yard line. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and two. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, it makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
So they're operating in the red zone. His way up to about the 14. He can muster a little yard there, and they'll be left with a third and very short. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the 3. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal.
Okay, no score on that play, but this guy's been a touchdown machine all year long. You know they trust him with the football.
They'll come up now in the Wildcat package.
Let's go!
This is Martin. And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it will be second down.
Jason Pierre-Paul first burst on the scene for me, headed towards his draft year.
Let's go!
And I saw him there, like 15, 16
points. He's in. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Done, Martin.
Level of the guys up front blocking, the offensive linemen, maybe the smartest guys in football overall. Add in a little bit of athleticism and a whole lot of toughness, you got a lot to deal with, don't you?
That's why the guys in the backfield get them really nice Christmas gifts, right?
If they're smart, they do.
The Bucs ready for the kickoff, and here we go. It's in the air. Now it's Chris Thompson on the return. Take this one near the 25, put at the 26-yard line. And the Giants ready to come out now. And two interceptions already here in this first half. That's got to affect him a little bit, right? He's got to be thinking about it.
He's got to be thinking about it, but most of the good ones, they find a way to put it aside. They're not happy about it by any stretch of the imagination. They find a way to put it aside and continue to play their game.
Can he put it aside? Let's find out. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Jordan McCoy is always going to be linked with Ndamukong Suh. They came into the NFL in the same draft class. There's a lot of debate about who is going to be the better defensive tackle. They just do it two different ways. McCoy, more movement, more elusiveness. That allowed him to make the play there for a short game.
Let's see what the offense comes with here. Second and 8.
Detroit! Detroit!
Is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
Well, that's what you're looking for when you're wanting to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
Oh, They get the completed pass, but still have more to go here on third down.
Here we go now.
They'll drop the throw. Gets it to Benjamin. It's caught. And he will have the first down as they get into the ground at the 37.
They're a close game. Loose threats of finding the way to catch the ball and some traffic for a key first down.
Job of adjusting to the ball in the air. Not the most accurate of throws, but able to adjust and make the grab. And again, this time to the tailback. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage.
A one-yard gain can look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of one-yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional one-yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group.
Here we go. All right now. Look at 56.
This is Freeman on first and 10. Will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now and they want to get out there.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go around. Formation won't yield much here as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. He was brought down by Devon Kennard. So 2 minutes to go in a wild first half. Back with more NFC playoff action after this. Sniffed out well defensively, and it brings up third.
So many things have to come together just right for a screen pass to break for big yardage. The blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner, everything has to fit together just right. But on that play, the defense was able to disrupt things and hold it to a short game.
All right, here we go. 319.
And they'll send the tight end in motion here.
Detroit.
On third down, they'll drop to throw. And he dropped it. Now it was tipped. Altered the ball a little bit, but he dropped it. And now fourth down.
Anytime the ball's thrown in the middle of the field has popped up in the air, I expect someone to catch. It doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense, because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Pulled in at the 24. It'll be a 47-yard punt with a net of 40 following a 7-yard return. And it'll be Giant football first and 10. New York set to take the field. And it's a unit last drive They did it all on the ground, Charles.
And they controlled it from the interior, big on big, right? Offensive lineman versus defensive lineman. But you know, in order to keep the football moving downfield, other people have to get involved as well.
Go ahead and take another timeout. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. From here forward. Well, they've gone backwards so far in this series, third and 13. Play fake as they set up the throw. And for the third time, this happens intercepted. Hooked on by Greg Grimes. And they are going to set up shop at the 3-yard line. Now the Buccaneers offensive unit back out on the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them.
Swarming to the line.
Detroit! Detroit! Set! Speed! 19! No. Check! Patriots! Patriots! Now let's go!
Now this time they look to throw. It's caught by Mike Evans. And they're able to get this one past the 30 down to the 25.
Everything about that play was beautiful. A great corner route where the receiver worked the defensive back inside and then worked back to the outside to the corner. But how about the throw by the quarterback? Anticipation on the break from inside to outside. He threw the football. As the receiver turned around, the ball greeted him.
And on second and 10 now. Second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. On the right hash, it's a 43-yard attempt. And Aguayo's kick is good. And that will do it for this first half. So we've come upon halftime here in this NFC divisional round matchup. As we'll send you down the coast to Orlando, where we check in with our friend Larry Ridley and the EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry? Will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Well, New York set to take the field. They're down. here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're bad. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we get the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. So now 11 yards to go for this offensive unit. It's second down.
Hurry up, here we go. All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56.
All right, now, lucky 56.
Blue, lucky 56.
Blue, and they're going to go soft on the corners. They look to throw. It's caught. They got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets them a new set of downs.
X's and O's, and that's exactly what they did there.
They'll give it to him right up the gut. Able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
Boy, what would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. The Pro Bowler Odell Beckham, the intended receiver, and it's 3rd and short. And maybe now got to shift up what you want to do on the playbook.
Yeah, definitely. Change what you're doing in the playbook, but boy, the advantage shifts to the guys on defense, doesn't it? Longer yardage situations, they often become bolder.
And again here, we'll see the Wildcat.
Here we go! One, two!
And the gadget package here won't do much for him. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Oh, no gain on the play, and it'll be 2nd down. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick. And what a terrific play. Holding him in no gain.
And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And he got blown up on that play. Back at the 20. And the dreaded third and long here for the offense. So he's on to punt it away. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And no one there to stop it. Hits at the 8, but it carries all the way into the end zone for a touchback. And New York set to take the field. And they'll be looking to build off of a nice drive last time, a drive that really relied on the quarterback.
Making good decisions, distributing the ball well, distributing it accurately, keeping it away from danger. A really nice run drive.
But now the defense, what adjustments do they need to make in the passing game?
Pass rush. Pull some guys up front, or maybe you bring additional guys, but you've got to disrupt the timing of them throwing the ball.
We'll see if they can disrupt it here. Just 1 yard to go here on second down.
This is where your running game can really help you with the lead in the second half.
I agree totally.
It's not just end of the half situations that you worry about the clock. It's throughout the game. And with a lead, stay in bounds. They come fight harder and try and catch you.
And a nice carry there, 15 yards.
I know anytime you watch a team run the ball really well, there's a pinball effect. People bouncing off of each other. There's also some things of beauty in there. You see these nice, explosive, strong runs. This guy, he knows how to carry the football really well and continually wants the football. Why? He knows the offensive line's going to give him great effort, and he gets great effort himself to finish off runs.
So the run gets him the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs. A handoff, Devontae Freeman. Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, second down. He makes a wonderful play there off the corner, protecting his side of the field.
Oh, that reminds me of the great defenses of old, doesn't it? The Pittsburgh Steelers, Steel Curtain, they would not let you get on the field if you could only do one thing. You had to be a complete guy, and you had to be able to tackle.
Now, I know I've said this before, but you know I wasn't alive when the Steel Curtain was playing. I know them, but I just want to let you know I wasn't alive.
I'm going to keep putting that in there, and one of these days you're going to think that you were.
They come out here in the eye. Again, they'll run with Freeman. And strong running there as he's inside the 10 and down to the 8-yard line. And he gets them a little over half of what they need, and now they're looking at a 3rd and 5. Play number 7 now coming up on the drive. 3rd and 5.
Watch it now, Barney.
Looking for Odell Beckham that time. And that brings up 4th down. So on 4th down, Pete Carroll's going to call out his field goal unit. This from 25 yards out. And his kick is indeed good. And that'll make this a 7-point game. It's a short kick taken at the 15. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. And now the Buccaneers offense gets set to head back onto the field. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They're going to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. And they'll go on the ground. Found a little room there as he's out to about the 37. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and 4. And they're going to hurry back to the line now.
So much of the game today, they're looking for hybrid players, guys who can do a combination of jobs. And anyone who plays a strong safety position, now more than ever, is a hybrid type player. Half defensive back that covers passes, and half linebacker that makes tackles. We just saw the linebacker make that play.
And 3 full yards here for the offense to get on third down. Defense showing blitz. And 5 in the secondary now for the Giants on third down. A strong run. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of 1.
Brandon, that play ended so fast, it's almost as if the quarterback handed it to the runner and the tackle was there right away for a loss of yardage.
Back now here at MetLife Stadium. It's Buccaneer football, but they've got work to do. They find themselves behind here to start the fourth quarter. And this will be taken at the 13. Give him 11 yards that time on the return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The New York set to take the field. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 point kicker. Exactly. You got it through the post. It's going to help in the contract time. But the offense, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that would help in the contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that. Super tough.
The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked over the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
Let's go! B-19! Detroit!
Play action. They'll throw. Surveying the field. He's going to sling this deep. It's caught inside the 25. It's a big-time play there for the G-men. 54 yards. Well, even after all those interceptions, he's not deterred, still confident to go deep at work there.
I think all the old rules about playing that position still apply. If things go wrong, you still act like you're the best player out on the field. You still carry that supreme arrogance with you and continue to fire the ball. I've seen guys have games like this, and this is where you find out if you're great or not. Come some interceptions and still lead your team to victory.
It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. And this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take. It's a little bit more pressure on the good offensive line.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards on the carry there, and it leaves him with 3rd and about 6 yards to go.
I know the toss play begins with the guy taking the snap and turn around and tossing it to the runner. But where the real intrigue is, can they seal the edge? Whether it's an offensive tackle or a tight end in the direction they want to run the football. If they do that, that's the result that you get, that type of a game. If they don't, oftentimes it's not a very successful play.
On third down, Devontae Freeman. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. It's a gain of 5, and now the question, will the offense stay out there on 4th and 1?
So many things go into making a good play on defense. In this situation, just not being blown out of the way was a big start, and then a nice tackle to finish things off.
And his kick is good. And that will push the lead up to double digits now at 10. So his second field goal of the game, and that could turn out to be the big one.
Yeah, you have to make him score twice to beat you, and that's not impossible. But here in the fourth quarter, puts their backs clearly against the wall.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for the offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
A good start there on first down. They've got to have this drive.
No doubt about it. Down a couple of scores. They have to find a way to put it in the end zone. Some plays, explosive plays, that will be the key to this drive.
And they'll go ground game here in the tailback. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage.
Keep your tight ends a little bit more. Maybe the running backs help you a little bit with the pass blocking. But you've got to help them get some confidence because you can't abandon the play call.
And he's going to be stopped up right at the line of scrimmage. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out.
Time is end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there.
Let's get three, right?
They come up with an offset eye, and they'll give it here to his running back. And he's got about 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 25. The Pro Bowler Greg Grimes brings him down.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here.
I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up to play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
Team out there for the Giants as they will send this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
How many times have we started meetings with coaches and they use the term complimentary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the this is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Let's see if they can be quick and recover. And the hole closes quickly there. He gets maybe a couple up to the 38. Time for a break. We'll come back to wrap this one up after this. Here we go with 2nd and 7. Shipped together here from the D-line. A gain of 7 on the play, and it sets up a 3rd and inches situation. And now they're in the hurry up.
And once again, the offensive line lower than the defensive front. They moved them and found some good space for the guy carrying the ball.
Officially a gain of just a yard there, but they do convert on 3rd and inches.
I always appreciate runners who understand situations. That was just 3rd and inches. No reason to dance around in the backfield and try and break off a bigger play. Just go pick up the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
Offense comes to the line now, 1st and 10. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Pass coverage looked defensively. That's complete. It's down. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up 2nd down. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. And they're going to speed things up here.
Let's go.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. It's a loss of 4. And a 3rd down. Really good defensive effort. They were all over that. A swing pass out to the right side with a loss yard.
Execution and done with a lot of enthusiasm. Well,
yeah, absolutely.
They saw it all the way, ran to the football, and caused a nice play for lost yardage.
And they'll go with a ground attack here. Room here to run. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 21 line. A big time play there on 3rd and 9. 36 yards. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive.
All right, here we go. All right, now, Lockett 56. Lockett 56.
They'll look to throw now on 1st down. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Their dangerous wide receiver. A 16-yard touchdown. And the Bucs are able to close the gap just a bit.
Everyone's got 4. Time over! Over! Over!
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he is going to be stopped short of the goal line. Oh, they'll mark him inside the 1. He just couldn't keep churning those extra few inches. And the 2-point attempt is turned aside. Just about put a camper on this one. They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none. Well, the Buccaneers go ahead and take another timeout. That'll be their 2nd, so 1 more chance to stop the clock here. And we'll be back. And they'll indeed take a knee. Now hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. It'll be their 3rd and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. And they take a knee. It's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
As an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn. And this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. The Giants are winners as we say so long from MetLife Stadium.